morning, children. Today we are going to talk about one such exercise from our chapter 3. You see your page number 30. Okay, till now we have completed 3 chapters, and this the Bermuda Triangle we have already discussed. The question answers we have done, and one question from your words in use are done. Now we are going to talk about this word, what is the structures A and B number. If you can see in your book, this question number A and B. Okay, so now what here you have to do is that you have to use has or have plus been plus ing. Now in our previous year, we had already talked in grammar about this conjugation of verbs, and we had also seen how we form. And basically here we are going to talk about only present tense. If you don't remember, then I'm going to show you. You remember how many parts of this types of present tense are there? They are having, see, first of all we are having tense, then this tense is divided into 3 parts. Okay, present, past and future. And this every 3 tenses, every present tense, every past tense and every future tense, they are divided, again they are redivided, they are subdivided into 4 more groups, right? Okay, so the first one is simple present, or we call it as present indefinite tense. Then secondly we have present continuous tense, then we have present perfect tense, and then lastly we have present perfect continuous tense. I'll very quickly I'll show you the pattern how we do that. Okay, so let's start. First of all we'll start with simple present. This is just for revising once more so that you can now understand how we do this questions. Okay, where we add what. So first if we take simple present, then how do we make it? I'll make one box only and then I'll show you. First, second, third, then singular number and plural number this side, okay? And these are our person. You already know this, we are just revising. And this is our number. Let me make it here singular. And this is our plural. First, second, and now third. Okay, so we are first talking about simple present. So let us take any verb. Let us see here our first verb in the bracket, it is work. So let's do with work only. With every verb it remains the same, only the persons remain the same, only the verb changes. Okay, first of all let us put this I, we, you, you, he, she, it and they. Yeah, we had already discussed about this. Now as per our verb, as this is in simple present, we are only going to talk about present tense. Okay, I work, we work, you work, you work, he, she, it works. Remember, with he, she, it we put S or ES. And lastly, they work. This is our first division of present tense, that is simple present tense. Now we'll do present continuous tense. Now what we are supposed to do, we will put here auxiliary. I am working, we are working, you are working, Again here you are working. He, she, it is working and they are working. Done? This is our second. Present continuous tense means what? First of all, simple present tense means what? It remains the same. Today also it's same. Tomorrow also it will be same. That means habitual action, or you can say universal truth. Okay. Then next we have this present continuous tense, the thing which is going on right now. Okay. The thing which is right now going on. Suppose for now, I am watching my English tutorial video. Just like we are now doing this, so you are watching the video. So in that case, you can say that I am watching my English class tutorial, or I am watching my English tutorial video, like that. Then our third one is present perfect tense. Now what happens in this one is that your work has already been finished. Okay, the work has finished, but in the present time. Okay, in the present. Let me make here. I'll make two boxes now, this side. Okay, first of all, it is first, second, third. Then singular will be there and plural. Okay, now shall we take another... let's take another word. Let us take play. I have played. My space has become small. I have played, we have played, you have played, you have played. Done? Now the thing you have to care for here is that with I, with basically the third person singular number, only the have or has, okay, changes. Everywhere if you see, I have put have, okay? I have, we have, you have, you have. Now, he, she, it, what we are going to put? Has. Played. Okay? And again, when we write for they have played. Yes? This is the thing. Now, the thing which we are actually going to work in our exercise question. This is the next one. This is the next type. Why I showed this? So that you can be cleared about in which type it is falling, and you can know or you can revise once again. Okay. Now, see, what we have to do here is, we have to use has or have, depending on our person, plus been. Now, if you see this, we have done till now three subdivisions of present tense. Have we got in any of the part till now, been, the word been, have we got? No, we have not. That means we have finished simple present tense. It was, been is not used there. We have used present continuous tense. Again, it is not used there. And we have used present perfect tense also. It is not used there. So the last thing which is remaining, or the last type or subdivision which is remaining, is what is that? Present perfect continuous tense. Okay, now this one, how we write, we have to see. I have, let me remove this plate because it will change, okay? Now, I have been playing. Now, as we had discussed, simple present tense, the thing which always is happening, the second present continuous, which is happening right now, okay, in the present time, and then the third one is present perfect tenses, which has finished, the work which I was doing is finished, okay, I have completed, and the fourth one, this present perfect continuous tense is this, I have started and I have been doing, okay. It is going on. It is little different from your second one, that is present continuous. Okay, it is little bit different from that. So let's see how we place it. You have been playing. Again, we have, sorry, been playing. You have been playing, they have been playing, he, she, it has been playing. Done? So this is the way how we write in each of the subdivisions of tenses. Now let's see how we do our questions, or how do we place them in proper sentences. So number one question is already done for you. You can take the help of this example. See, father is tired. Try to understand the question. Okay, father is tired. He worked all night. The word work, or the verb work, is used. Now you have to show this in the present perfect continuous tense form. So how we are supposed to write? Father is tired. He has been working all night. Okay, this is the thing. Then number two also I'll show you. Vinod played with that puzzle for an hour. He clearly he likes it. Now that means Vinod likes to play with the puzzle, and see what is written here. Vinod played with that puzzle for an hour. For an hour. Somehow you can feel the connection. Vinod has been playing with that, yes, with that puzzle for an hour. Clear about this? And then three number will remain same, four number only I'll show, because you have to question this. Right now we are only making sentences. Two and three, these are sentences, but four number, it is a question. You work in the garden. Okay? No wonder you are covered in mud. Begin, have. That means you have to question this with, sorry, number four. You work in the garden. You work in the garden. That means you have to place this in that way. So we have to start with have. Okay, let me show you. First of all, let's write this in the sentence itself. You have been working. Right? Yes. Working in the garden. Now, if we question this, then how we are supposed to question? Have, then our subject. Always auxiliary come first when we make questions. Our auxiliary, then our subject, you, then the remaining. Been working in the garden. Then this is the thing. Now your B number also, it's going to be same. Shall we? Okay, let's do 5 number, because see, you'll remember one thing, whatever the questions are, you need to first see, because your main thing about this question is to place has or have been. Okay, as this is to place has or have been, that means it depends on our what? Person. Okay, you have to see what the person is. Father is third person. Vinod, name of a person, again third person. He is a man. If you can't understand by what father is, generally he is a male. Okay, masculine gender. So for masculine gender, what pronoun do we use? We use he. That's why it is, it has been written as has been. Then with you, we have placed have. Because always remember, I, we, you, they. With this 4, we place have. And only one, with a third person singular number only, we place has. Clear? Last one I'll show you. Number 5. Again, you have to make the question here. How you make question is this. Prem go to music school. Okay. Prem has been going to music school. Done? Now we'll question this. First of all, auxiliary. Has. Then our subject. Prem. Then the remaining. Been going to music school? Question mark. Okay, the remaining part you can write also, or you can skip also. I hope you have understood the pattern. We have just revised it once again. We have already got in our previous year in grammar, we had got it, and I had already taught you, but this is just a revision so that you can recall it back. Okay, and yes, I may give you this. I made this video so that in when I give you sometime later, that some assignments or something, or any homeworks, some kind of like that, so you can do this. Okay, you will be able to do this. And regarding this A and B, and this is remaining words in use, A number, I'll give this, then you can note it up. Okay, so till then, stay safe and thank you.